How to remove the background from a transparent glass, that's the topic we are going to talk about today. So let's jump into it. So here we have a glass with a white background, and that's the image we are going to use as our background. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a path of this subject. I have already created a mask in order to remove the white background from the surrounding of the glass. So I'm going to activate the mask by simply press shift from the keyboard and click on this mask, and you see the background has been removed already. So I'm going to click and drag this object into our new background. I'm going to press Ctrl T to reduce the size. Okay, so this is our object. Now you can see the white background from the glass. Now here we need to do two things. First, we need to remove the white background, and second, we need to preserve the shadows of the background. So what I'm going to do first now, I'm going to change the blending mode from normal to multiply. Once you do that, you can see all the whiteness from the glass has been disappeared. Now only you can see the shadows of the glass, all the whiteness has been gone. This is what happened when you select the multiply mode. When you select this multiply mode, all the whiteness from your layer disappeared. So only shadows or dark pixel remains, and all the whiteness get removed from the layer. So here you can see the white background from the glass has been disappeared. That's what we want, but the shadows are very dull. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to press Ctrl J to make another copy of the object. Now you can see the shadows are fine there. Now I'm going to press another copy to get my highlights back. Now you can see the glass is very dull. We can't see any highlights there, the shine. I'm going to create another layer by pressing Ctrl J. And now I have the third layer. I'm going to change the blending mode from multiply to screen. So what we go here now, we go this layer for the shine and these two layers for the shadows. Let me rename them so you know what we're talking about. So I'm going to rename this layer as a shine, and I'm going to select these two layers and press Ctrl G, and I name it shadows. Double click on this layer to get the layer style options, and here I'm going to use this blend if options. And in blend if option, I'm going to focus on this layer. So basically what I wanna do here, I wanna remove all the shadows and the whiteness from the glass, but I wanna preserve the shine in the glass. So I'm going to remove all the shadows by moving this light on the right. Now you can see all the shadows are start disappearing from the screen, you see. But you can see all those highlights are still there. So I'm going to move this slider all the way on the side until I will start seeing. That's it. Now you can see the background has been removed from the glass, but those harsh edges there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to press Alt from the keyboard or Option for the Mac users, and I click on this gray icon, and I'm going to break that apart. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to move this slider all the way to right to get those whiteness slightly nicely blend with the image. So if I move in this side on the side, you can see all the highlights are coming back, but the highlights are very nicely blended with the image. So I will move it the way I want it, for example, like that. That is fine. So now I'm happy with the image and I press OK. So you see simple two options, one for the multiply to remove all the whiteness from the image, and the second is screen mode to remove all the shadows from the image, and then we use the blend if option to remove all the shadows and highlights and preserve our shining from this layer and remove everything else. Now you can see the image is very nicely blended with the background and everything is there. Now we are going to add shadows into the glass. But before that, if your glass layer is not blending nicely with your background, here is a quick tip for you. So simply create another layer, solid color layer, and pick any color from, for example, this one, and press OK. Now I want to preserve this color only onto the glass. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to press Alt from the keyboard, and you see this mask here from the shine. I'm going to press Alt from the keyboard and Option for the Mac user, and I click on this mask and click and drag and put mask on top of the new adjustment layer we created, and replace mask, yes, press OK. Now you can see all the color we just created is only affecting the gloss layer. So here you can double click on this and pick any color from here what you think is nicely blending with the gloss. Press OK. Now go to the blending options and click color. And that's it. Now simply reduce the opacity. That's it. You can change the color according to your background, and for me this will do the job. And now I'm going to add shadow to the gloss. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create another layer and press B from the keyboard to get the brush, and hardness all the way 0, and size should be big enough to cover the bottom of the glass. I think that will do the job. Let's change the color from black and click once. We got the shadow there, so now slightly move the shadow underneath the gloss all the way down just above the background layer underneath the gloss. Now press Ctrl T to transform and adjust the shadow accordingly, just underneath, and change the blending mode to multiply. Always, most of the time we use multiply to blend the shadows with the background nicely. And once you are happy with the background, simply reduce the opacity, press Ctrl 0. Okay, now that is fine. Now you can see our gloss has been nicely blended with the background, and all the unnecessary whiteness from the gloss has been removed. Now there are two things here. First, the shine on the gloss is too sharp. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click the shine layer and reduce the opacity slightly. Now that should be fine. Okay, 75 will do the job. And lastly, there's another thing we need to pay attention to. If you pay attention on the background, we have a noise on the background, but the gloss is very transparent, very sharp. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little noise on the gloss. I'm going to create another layer by pressing Ctrl Shift N to create a new layer, and I'm changing the blending mode from overlay and fill with the neutral 50% gray. Okay, so now you can see nothing's happened on the screen. So basically what happened, I have created a new layer and I fill up with the 50% gray, and if you change the blending option from overlay to normal, you can see the gray there, but I don't want to see the gray here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the blending option from normal to overlay. Basically I don't want to see any color on the screen, I just want to add the noise. But in order to add the noise, I need to get a new layer and fill up with the any color so I can add the noise. So go to the filter and noise and add noise, and here let me zoom in. Make sure this option is checked, and I think 2 should be fine. Okay, now you can see our gloss has been nicely blended with the background. If you want to preserve the noise just to the gloss only, you can again copy the mask from the underneath layer, press hold and click and drop the mask on the noise layer. So before and after. Before and after. Now you get the idea how to remove the background from the glass. Having said that, it really depends what kind of background you have behind your glass mirror. If it's a white background, it would be a lot easier for you to remove the background the way I just mentioned. And if you have a different color in the background, it would be slightly harder to remove the background, but there are other ways you can do that too. So I hope this tutorial will help you out, and if you have any questions, feel free to drop the line comment section. If you have come to my channel first time, please go ahead and click the subscribe button in order to get all the tips and tricks and new tutorial regarding the Photoshop. And if you learned something out of this video, please do click the like button, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.